Configurations and policies are ways to configure a device. A configuration is generally a collection of settings for a device, and a policy creates requirements for how the device can behave. You'll have specific needs for the policies in your environment, so we're not going to cover policies as part of the best practice series. We can make a few recommendations for configurations, though. Some of the configurations are fairly simple, and others are more complex. Let's start with some of the simple ones. Open the configurations by navigating to Configurations, click Add, and then select the type of configuration you want to create. While we generally recommend setting apps up as in-house, there may be some apps that you want to distribute through the Google Play Store instead. For those apps, or for apps that are installed on the device by default, such as Android WebView, you can still control when the app updates to a new version using a managed Google Play configuration. You can set apps to update only during a specific window of time, only over Wi-Fi, never, or always. For example, some of the ways you could use this are, if you set this configuration to none, then by default no apps would update from the Google Play Store. Then, on an app-by-app basis, configure the apps that you want to update regularly, separately. Or, for apps that are mission-critical, you may want to have a test group update regularly, while most devices are set to not update. Then, after the test group verifies that the update is successful, you can change the configuration for the other devices and allow them to update. If you configure the settings in a general configuration and for a specific app, be aware that the app configuration is what's used. The default app runtime permissions are useful to grant apps permissions without prompting the user. This particular configuration would grant permissions to all apps that requested them. If you'd prefer to grant the permissions on a per-app basis, like we did when we configured Velocity, you can do that during the app configuration step. A Wi-Fi configuration provides the device with the Wi-Fi SSID and security information. I'm sure you can see how useful that is, so we're not going to spend much time on it, just point it out so you can use it. And finally, there are a few default configurations that you probably want to turn off or set to no devices. If you are using corporate BYOD, you may want these on still, but for many supply chain customers, they are not a good fit. Search for Work Profile in the existing configurations, and you'll see the Android Enterprise Work Profile Android for Work, and the Android Enterprise Managed Device with Work Profile on Company-Owned Device configurations. Set those so they are not distributed to devices.